I looked up to my brothers for many things when I was younger. The four of them were all so unique and talented in their own ways. One way in which they were all similar, though, was in the ability they had with a pen and paper, and that is what I looked up to the most. As I was growing up, there were all sorts of drawings and doodles left all over the house. I remember picking them up and saying to myself, "One day I will draw exactly like this." My brothers were much older than I was, so they never took me under their wing and showed me what they knew. I had to learn all by myself. The first art I began to create were in the pages of my coloring books. I remember trying so hard to stay within the lines because that's what one of my brothers casually mentioned when he walked by my room one day and saw me lying on the floor with crayons scattered all around me. I took this little piece of advice very seriously. I practiced coloring between the lines until the pictures were perfect. When I went to show my brother, he was pleased. This made me so happy. I was very young, and the page I colored wasn't much, but it gave me the encouragement I needed to know that someday I, too, could be like my brothers. As I got older, my art matured. I was no longer trying to stay within the lines of the coloring book. I now graduated to pens, pencils, markers, colored pencils, paint, along with a blank piece of paper. I was much more creative than I ever thought I could be. Ideas came flowing from my mind, through my hand, and onto the paper. I no longer drew because I wanted to be like my brothers. I drew because I loved doing it. I loved thinking about something, abstract or not, and giving it life on a piece of paper. It was something I did with whatever spare time I had. Finally, when high school came, that's when my abilities really began to flourish. I learned everything I needed to know about art from an amazing teacher. This teacher really knew his stuff and wanted you to know it too. He never doubted you for a second. Anything you set your mind to, he would support you. And when you were done, he would offer his open-minded, never negative, always beneficial criticism. Through this class and this teacher, I learned so many new things. I created pieces with mediums I had never used before. This expanded my capabilities far greater than I ever imagined. Although I never really got to show my brothers any of my work because they were all moved out of the house by this time, I know they would be proud of me. They would also be surprised at the things I could do. If there's one thing my brothers and my old art teacher taught me, it's to always believe in yourself. We can achieve things we never thought possible if we just try. One of the drawings that belonged to one of my brothers that I picked up when I was little was this really detailed pencil drawing of Wolverine. I found it fascinating and decided to keep it. It was what kept me going every day and made me push myself harder and harder to be able to do something like that one day. If it weren't for my brother's influence and my teacher's motivation, I would have just given up on drawing and may have become a different person than who I am today. Being able to express myself on a paper really gave me an escape from reality that everyone needs sometimes.